Hey guys, Todd here with Power Driven, and we recently just released a Power Driven S480 Turbo. When we were designing that turbo, we had to decide to use a divided housing or a new undivided housing. We chose the undivided, and this is why. Alright guys, so what is a divided housing versus non-divided housing? So this is called a turbine scroll, and this is actually called a twin scroll turbine housing, meaning they divided the housing into basically two housings, two small housings, twin scrolls, where this guy is called a single scroll housing. So if you're online, that's what those terms mean. Non-divided, single scroll, divided, twin scroll. How does this work? Why was this invented in the first place? And you can see that the exhaust is separated front to back, the rear three cylinders, the front three cylinders, and they fire opposite each other. What they're trying to do with the divided housing, the twin scroll, is to isolate the exhaust pulse from each cylinder into its own chamber. It's small here, and then it goes into its corresponding chamber here. That way, each pulse is in a much smaller or tighter AR housing. This yields up awesome spool up. This is designed for low RPM performance. That's the reason this exists. This housing was designed for a over-the-road semi-truck application, and those are all very low RPM engines. So for spool up, the divided housing twin scroll is king. It works awesome. The problem is once your RPMs climb, if you have a high RPM engine, you're gonna have these pulses start backing up in this thing. They're gonna be dry pressure issues. You're not having the advantage of the whole entire large AR because it's divided into two small ARs. So again, works for slow speed, not great for high speed. So the problem with the divided housing happens with RPMs rise. This is designed for low RPM, it works great there, but it's divided all the way through. Like this exhaust pulse comes through this, it goes to small housing, it's divided all the way through the whole entire turbine housing, clear to the turbine wheel. So that exhaust pulse hits half the turbine wheel, it's confined to a half AR turbine housing. There's no benefit to this at any high RPM application. The only benefit for this is low RPM spool up, but that's it. And it works great in those applications. But for me, for high performance stuff, I don't love it. If I'm north of 1500 horsepower, this becomes a liability. This thing absorbs a ton of heat. This thing melts. Any turbo I've hurt, it's because I've melted out the divider. And so now when I race my trucks, I only use non-divided turbos on my trucks because I have spent a ton of money because I've melted out this little piece right here. So why undivided? When your RPMs get high, the undivided housing, that exhaust pulse, diffused into the entire turbine housing, the whole AR. You can really drop that drive pressure, which is a huge benefit for making power. It's not backing up and it just works awesome. So with this thing gone, you don't have to risk it melting. The reason this melts is it absorbs energy. Anytime you absorb energy, you're absorbing heat. That heat you want to go to the turbine wheel. The turbine wheel is what extracts power from heat and pressure. So if you're losing it into the divider, it's just a little less efficient. Now, most guys who buy an S480 and a small cubic inch engine like a diesel pickup truck, not a semi truck, this is not mounted to the exhaust manifold. It's actually downstream of the manifold. So what happens is you have this guy mounted here, and this guy gets exhaust flow into here. That's how compound work. Exhaust comes out here, goes into this one. There's no more pulse energy maintained this side of the turbine wheel. It's all been diffused. It's now just exhaust flow. So there's no benefit you're gonna gain from the divided housing right here. You still lose all the bad things. Your high RPM performance is going to suffer. You have more heat absorption through the divider, which is lost energy to the turbine wheel. And it's just gonna be less efficient overall. This housing doesn't exist in the world as far as I know. I've never seen an S400 non-divided housing, but a ton of these are used in compound turbos all over the country. There are a lot of these turbos and trucks out there. So I wanted to design a turbine housing that was beneficial in every way for a compound turbo system. I also wanted to offer a different flange. These all come with a large 5-inch full Marmon flange. And most guys, myself included, adapt that down to a 4-inch pipe. It's just this big, huge, fat 5-inch thing. It's a pain in the butt to work around. When we developed the PowerDriven 480, our whole goal was to make it easy to fabricate and fit under your hood. So we went with a 4.625-inch flange. This is the same flange like on your Borg 472. 4-inch outlet, you know, awesome flange, V-band flange, makes things very easy, more compact. We do offer the non-divided housing in the 5-inch flange. If you already have a turbo system and you want to take advantage of an undivided housing, you can just put this right in place if you're like your 132 divided housing. But if you're fabbing new, this will make your life a lot easier. Did it actually work? Is the philosophy true? Does the non-divided housing, is it superior to divided housing on the dyno? So we decided to put these things on our the Junker drag truck, which has a S480. The Powergen 480 has the atmosphere turbo. And we played merry-go-round with a bunch of different turbine housings, the Bork housings versus like the undivided, and let's look at the data, see which one was superior. All right, guys, let's pull up these data graphs and take a look at how the non-divided competes with divided housings. We've been over already why a divided housing is superior on a manifold directly bolted to your engine. What I'm more curious about, is there a benefit in the atmosphere charger arrangement where it's getting exhaust from the turbocharger? In my mind, I can't see any positive benefits of having a divided housing after a turbo, only detriment and negative effects. So I want to do a test where we had the same truck, same dyno, same day. We tried all three of these housings, the undivided 115, the PDD one, versus a 1.15 divided, versus a 1.32 divided, all as the atmosphere charger in a compound turbo system. And this is what you're looking at here. This is the graph. So quick, the dotted green line, right? My mouse is, the dotted green line is the undivided PDD housing. This is the 4-inch outlet. I wanted to see if that 4-inch was hurting it or not. This right here, the small dash is the 1.15. The large dash is the 1.32. Let's start at the very beginning of the runs. We have very, very precise fuel control on this truck. And so we started the exact same fuel every time. That's why our runs are very consistent. It's worth noting that the 1.15 PDD non-divided housing was always about 4 horsepower higher than the divided. Why is it consistently a little bit higher? I just think it's because it has better exhaust flow. There's not that big divided housing in the way of exhaust flow. It can move how it wants to. So let's go up. This is by engine speed. Let's look down here, you know, 2300 RPM. They're pretty similar. And the reason why is because this is a big turbo. It's kind of not in the game until RPMs come up. That's how compounds work. As your RPM comes up, big turbo comes in, big fun comes in. I think that's why this 4 horsepower here happened, is the better exhaust flow characteristics of the non-divided housing. It's like the big turbo wasn't there. It was just not in the way, so the smaller turbo can work more efficiently. The way a turbine works is pressure in versus pressure out. That delta, that difference. If you have a lot of pressure behind that turbo, it slows it down. If you have very little pressure behind that turbo, a free-flowing exhaust, it spools up quicker. So if you have a very restrictive turbo after your small turbo, it will actually sometimes hurt spool up of that small turbo. So here it shows it's about a 4 horsepower difference having that free or flowing exhaust, that 115 non-divided housing. The green line is horsepower, the yellow line is torque. Let's follow them on up. So when they start spooling here, we're like 2500 is where they really start kind of diverging. Let's go to interstage boost. Interstage boost is the pink. So 2300, 2200 is where they kind of start moving up. And they all start moving pretty quick by 2400. The fastest boost rise is the divided 1.15, which is kind of interesting. But when you compare it to the drive, you'll see here's the drive pressure of the 1.15. It follows suit. The drive's the highest, the boost is highest. What about power? It's making the most power. At 2600 RPM, it is tied with the 1.15 non-divided. So the 115 divided and undivided are pretty much tied at this point. The 132 is kind of falling behind. It's a pretty big housing. Interstage boost is actually high. The lowest interstage boost actually is the 1.15 non-divided. It's flowing through easiest. But the drive pressure is also the lowest. That's why the power is right here, is just as good as a 115. Really, these are all very, very similar until the boost really comes in. Right here, we start seeing the divergence. So the 132 is the slowest come up. It is the least powerful one on this particular truck. Maybe this truck needs more fuel, more RPM. The 132 would shine, but on a 1,000-ish horsepower truck, 900 horsepower truck, the 132 kind of comes in last place here. The boost, if you go down the purple line, so the boost between the lowest interstage boost of all turbos was the 115 non-divided. The exhaust just flows through it really well. Whatever it is, it's the lowest. It's kind of interesting. What's also interesting is it has a little bit higher drive pressure than the 132. So the boost is lower. Drives a touch higher, which it is a tighter housing than 132. It's interesting. I don't know why that exists, but the power doesn't lie. The 115 undivided is the most efficient. It really shines. And right here, the top ends really makes a big, big difference. We get 3100 plus. You can really see them diverge. The 115
The 132 kind of come together right here in the horsepower, and the 115 non-divided just keeps pulling away here. But again, this is through a 4-inch exhaust. These are both 5-inch exhaust outlets. This is a 4-inch exhaust outlet. I really wanted to see, could I make a 4-inch outlet compete the 5-inch outlet? On this truck, is no problem, actually won. And right here, let's look at the power difference here. I'm going over to the left side, the Dodge, so we're 875 horsepower at 3,300 RPM. This is with the 115 non-divided. The 115 divided is 852 horsepower, so 23 horsepower less. And the 132 is 847, so almost 28 horsepower less. So pretty big difference up top. I want to look at this versus time. This is engine speed. And so at engine speed, they're similar, but which one comes up quicker? Which one's faster? I would guess the faster one's gonna be the 115 because it started higher to begin with. Because of that little 4 horsepower increase, it's that better flowing exhaust. Let's look at engine time. So when you go by time, the differences become much more clear because even though it makes similar power levels, a little bit more at every RPM with the 115, since you're making more power levels, you accelerate to the next one quicker and quicker and quicker. So you can really see this in the time graph. So here we're all starting again to get that 4 horsepower difference. But by the time we're 3 seconds into the run, let's look right here. This is the 115 non-divided versus the 115 divided versus the 132 divided. So 3 seconds into the run, we are at 453 horsepower on the non-divided PDD housing versus 394 horsepower with the 115 versus 404 versus 132. So we're talking like a 50-ish horsepower difference at 3 seconds. That's a huge swing. This thing's just running away from the other trucks. And it just carries it the whole way. Like you, if you follow this green dot here, we're way ahead the whole time until right at this second right here, it's caught up, but then that top end pulls away. And the truck ends at the same RPM. If you notice on the other graph, they all end at the same RPM. And you can see right here is where they dive off. So we hit that end RPM about a half second earlier. So you're a half second ahead. It's a lot. In a drag race, that's a long way. Let's look at drive pressure here. The drive pressure is interesting because it actually climbs fastest on the 115 non-divided. This is where the wastegate on the small turbo opens and it dumps drive. At this point, we're going all through the big turbos and the 115 is middle of the road until high end. Then the 132 and 115 non-divided are about the same. The 115 being very high. Comparatively, it's much higher, tightest housing of the bunch. The interstage boost, again, is very interesting. We're making less interstage boost with 115 undivided, but yet it makes the most power. To me, again, this just shows it just flows. It exhaust flows through it easily. It is odd to me how it makes less boost interstage and more drive than 132. It's weird, interesting, I don't know what to tell you. But we are making more power, and that's pretty fun. Torque, same thing, we're way up on torque. So, to me, I've always thought this and I still like it. I think any vehicle that's not trying to take advantage of pulse optimization of your exhaust manifold, the divided housing is a detriment to your performance. It's not how exhaust flows, it's not how it moves. It's diffusing into a smaller area. Bigger ARs always yield more power, as long as it's within the realm of your engine, of course. But this one spooled up quicker as far as power is concerned, and it carried it better. Like, this is a win-win. Your power comes on earlier, you have more of it. It carries it later, you have more of it. So it's not like, we're not talking night and day difference here. They all work well. We're talking 20 to 40 horsepower, depending on the RPM range you're at. All right, so big power numbers were fun, but this setup can actually tow. A lot of people do tow with this same similar setup. This is an HE351 of the manifold paired with an S480. So we put a tow tune in this around 350-ish horsepower. All these turbos can easily handle this. Is one superior to another? What's the difference? Again, we have a slight advantage down here. That low power with the open housing just flows better. What here is we have is EGT. None of these turbos have any problem with this amount of fuel. They're all right here peaking at around 1,000 degrees. This orange dash for 1,000 degrees. And this is a real illustration of why compounds are awesome. If you guys have towed trucks through diesels that have an EGT gauge, and you haven't had compounds, you know when the hill starts, EGTs climb always. I remember the first time I put compounds in and I hit a hill, my EGT climbed, just like it did here, climbed up, peaked, the turbos came in, boost came in, and then they fell. So it's just wild to think that. So right here we're at 1,029 degrees, up here, 1,000 degrees. Goes up, peaks, and drops a little bit. It's just, It's so rewarding to see. It's so fun. Big fan of combo turbos. I think everybody needs them. Again, though, same exact feeling. This one, the fuel is identical. Again, the two divided housings are very, very similar. I have a couple little bumps here. These are some anomalies. Forget those. Just look at the average. The 115, again, makes a touch more power up top. The 115 undivided is ahead the whole way, always, in every situation, which is cool. The best EGT control, interestingly enough, was the 1.15 divided housing, the 132 and the 115 undivided are both very similar. I'm talking 30 degrees difference here, not really much, but it is interesting to see. As we've seen before, interstage was down on the 115 undivided. Boost was also down on the 115 divided, but yep, power's up. That means we're just flowing air through this engine way more efficiently. This is a very competent turbo for towing trucks and trailers, no problem. That 351 spools up quick. It really appreciates having that open housing behind it. Like, as your turbos get bigger, like let's say you had like a 362 on the manifold, a bit bigger turbine, having that freer flowing exhaust behind those turbos, you'll notice it even more because they're a little bit laggier than the 351, so they'll be penalized more by having a restrictive turbo behind them. Even in towing, the open housing is beneficial and it seems to be better in every way. Again, we're not talking like you have a whole new truck, it's gonna light you rolling fire, but it is better. All right, guys, this has been a very fun test personally to me. I've thought about this for years. I remember years ago seeing a company make a product, they put a divided hop pipe, meaning they divided the pipe from the small turbo to the big turbo and divided the housing. And I thought, that's silly, makes no sense. There's no pulse going on there. So when I had the chance to make my own housing, I thought, I am going to do undivided. I'm gonna see if this is true. The S480, S475 turbos are great. The problem is they all come with a divided housing because they're made for semi-trucks. And so after this testing, it really proved to me that what I thought all along was true, that in the atmosphere turbocharger, an undivided housing really seems to be superior in every way. It works awesome, flows well. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about this. And then my own personal kits in the future, I'll definitely be using this undivided housing in any 400 kit that I make in the future. Yeah, if you have any questions, give us a call, your Power Driven Diesel. And yeah, check you next time. Thanks, guys.